Welcome back to Scout. Now, recently I caught up with Daniel Jones of Savage Garden.
I do like Savage Garden.
Yes, you do. Now, he was actually quieter in the days of Savage Garden. Darren took much of that spotlight, yeah. But we sat down, had a big chat. He's very talented, and he actually owns the Level 7 Studios, which is the old 301 recording studios in Castlereagh Street in Sydney, and this is what he had to say. She's taking time. Justify all the hurt inside. Daniel, thank you for your time. Really appreciate you joining us. In about 2001, I think it was, you actually had the highest played song in the US of all time.
Mm.
At the APRA Awards, you, in your acceptance speech, said that, you know, before this happened, no one wanted to speak to you, and now everyone did, and just back off.
Yeah.
Can you tell me about that?
Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, when it rains, it pours. So when you're, I guess, the flavour of the month, you know, everyone wants to tell you and everyone wants to be associated with you, etc. We were pretty much rejected by, you know, 99% of the industry. Weren't interested, didn't want a bar of us. And later, we proved that there was actually a number one song on that original demo cassette. So these people out there in the industry do miss things. No one really knows what a hit song is until it's become a hit song. And at that particular point, I remember feeling frustrated about, you know, why don't people get this? Because without being cocky or even overconfident, I was so assured within myself that there was something in this music that they didn't get it at all. And that's kind of frightening in a sense, because there could be many artists out there now sitting on number one songs that the industry is ignoring. She's saying, love is like a barren place now, reaching out for human faith. It's like a journey I just don't have a map for. What are your current frustrations with the music industry? Look, it's, you know, it's a bit of a sad state out there at the moment. Record companies are afraid to go forward. And there seems to be some frustration in the industry at the moment with record companies not taking chances on new artists, and that's sad. So this is why this show, for me, is why I'm taking part of it. It's actually got a great belief behind it. You know, it's back to music again, that fuck the record companies for a second. Let's just deal with music. And that's how I really, you know, like that about this show.
Tell me what you've been up to since the days of Savage Garden.
Mainly studio work, mainly concentrating on new bands, new artists, producing, a little bit of writing, not as much as perhaps I used to, or not as much as perhaps I would like to.
Tell me about your family, because you've since been married and you've got kids.
Do I have any regrets? Not when I compare to what I've got now, which is a beautiful wife and a beautiful kid. You know, I really don't. Like, would I be more happier with them now, or being on the road with the Savage Garden, knowing that my family was back here? I would be miserable if I was away from them. So in life, your goals change, and my creativity and my positive energy and everything that I was putting into the band, the same energy is going into my family, so I have a successful family.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't make any money, actually cost me a fortune, but I have a successful family.
Expensive people, women.